It's no secret that the revolution in Far Cry 6 takes heavy inspiration from the Cuban Revolution. So how similar are these revolutions? And what compelled people like Kenny Rojas to revolt? Cuba in the early 20s. It's paradise for whoever owns the most money, that is. Later, with the help of the United States in 1952, Fulgencio Batista came to power in a military coup. It turns out, however, that when you give a man suddenly all the power he can have, he gets a little crazy. In the reveal trailer, a grenade is used as a metaphor for the County of Yara. Anton and Diego are pinned that prevent the rest from the grenade or the people from exploding. Batista wasn't like Anton. He came to power because of his greed. But there existed other Caribbean dictators that are more similar to Anton. For example, François Duvalier, the president of Haiti. He supported the black inhabitants of Haiti and hated the colonialists and anyone who descended from them. Later, when he died, his son took over, and he ruled the same way as his father. Eventually, he was charged with corruption and human rights abuse by the government that had overthrown him. The Cuban people were unemployed and starving, and they knew that Batista was to blame for it. He made deals with both the American and Cuban mafia, and he allowed other American companies to rule the Cuban economy. The perfect stage for a revolution. A lawyer by the name of Fidel Castro tried to overthrow Batista via legal means. Surprisingly, petitions and charges of corruption were shut down by the Cuban courts. Fidel Castro and his brother Raul decided to take a different route. If Batista wouldn't listen, then he must feel. The first attack was on the Moncada barracks in Santiago on the 26th of July. Fidel and Raul Castro gathered 70 fighters and attacked the barracks. Sadly though, they lost. According to Fidel Castro himself, 9 were initially killed, while 56 others were executed later. The Castro brothers fled to the mountains, but were eventually caught and arrested. Later, due to political pressure from other countries, Cuba released all political prisoners, including the Castro brothers. In Mexico, they received aid from experienced fighters, like Alberto Bayo, the leader of Republican forces in the Spanish Civil War, and Ernesto Che Guevara, an Argentine revolutionary. The Castro brothers, Guevara, Bayo, and other revolutionaries returned to Cuba on a yacht, planning to hide out in the mountains, which, if you haven't noticed, is a common theme in the revolution. Fidel and Raul Castro weren't the only revolutionaries. Multiple groups followed Castro's example. A group of students tried to attack the president's palace, assassinate Batista, and announce his death over a captured radio station. This attempt failed, and later, 4 survivors of this attack were killed in what is known as the Humboldt 7 massacre. There was also a naval mutiny at Cienfuegos. It was said that officials within the US embassy had promised US recognition if the mutiny was a success. In an ironic and sinister twist, Batista killed the rebels with the help of US-provided infantry vehicles and B-26 bombers. I'm sure some of these events will be in Far Cry 6, especially the first two have a high chance of being in the game. Propaganda is an important part of any revolution, so you will definitely take over that radio tower, instead of just blowing it up. There are a lot more events that happened during the Cuban Revolution, and I can't detail them all in this video. If you're interested in the complete events of the Cuban Revolution, I've provided some links together with my sources in the description. And while you're down there, don't forget to like and subscribe if you're interested in similar content I am planning to provide in the future. In the gameplay footage, you can see a lot of creative weapons being used, but also iconic and less iconic firearms. I won't go over them all, but here are some that caught my attention. The AK is one of the most iconic firearms in modern history, and it makes an appearance in Far Cry 6 as the AKM. Whenever I look at this weapon, I just want to overthrow my government and replace it with an equally as bad, if not worse one.
Disclaimer, I do not want to overthrow my government, and I am not responsible for any revolution that might happen after this video.
Something remarkable is that the Spaz 12 is also in the game, even though it was made in the 80s, showing that Far Cry 6 isn't a full copy of the Cuban Revolution. Molotov cocktails were used extensively during the revolution. They were easy to make, but very effective. Guevara described a weapon called the M16, and it's not the assault rifle of the US military. It was a 16 gauge break breech shotgun that was modified to shoot Molotov cocktails. It was made by using a sort of shotgun loaded with an empty shell. A bottle of gasoline on a stick would then be inserted into the muzzle. This installation could fire a Molotov cocktail 100 meters or more with a fairly high degree of accuracy, according to Guevara. This would definitely be a fun weapon to use in Far Cry 6. I expect there would also be save points in the city from revolutionary sympathizers. Just like sympathizers in the Cuban Revolution provided food, rest and homemade weapons like Molotov cocktails for the revolutionaries. So how does a revolution start? For me, a revolution is caused by three pillars. 1. A motive to revolt. This could be the drive to survive, because people are hungry, anger, because of severe punishment, or will for your county, like wanting to make your county better. 2. Communication and organization. You can't organize and recruit without communication. So letting people know that they are not alone and that there is a chance for change is essential. Strength in numbers. Resources. You need weapons, equipment, transport, and funding to keep hope up and to be able to keep fighting. This is just my opinion though, and I'm sure yours could differ a lot. So this is the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and I hope that you will return for more of my content. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. So this is my video, my first one, and I'm glad it's over, but I'll have to edit this. But I hope you enjoyed my content, and I hope I'll see you back. I'm going to bed now. Sleep well.